In the last video, I showed you how to take that flat image and turn it into a much more dynamic one by correcting the exposure. So now we're going to look at the second step of the color correction process by adjusting the white balance for the best colors in your shots. Hey everyone, Camber here, showing you how to use your camera to make good videos. So if you're new, consider subscribing and also joining my private Facebook group where I can better answer your filmmaking questions. But when it comes to color correction, there are two main parts to making your image look good. First, you have to edit the exposure, and once you have it the way you like, then you need to move on to edit the image for white balance or color. And the reason for this is because any change in your exposure is going to also cause changes to the colors of your image. So in this video, we're going to look at some shots from one of my short films that we corrected the exposure for in the last video, and now we're going to adjust those images for white balance to get better colors. And the most important thing when it comes to white balance is trying to get it as correct as possible in camera for the best results. So if you need some help with setting the correct white balance, then check out any of these videos here on white balance presets, Kelvin white balance, or custom white balance to help you get the best colors in camera. So now, let's head over to the computer. All right, we're back here in Final Cut Pro and looking at the same clips that we used last time that we corrected the exposure for, and now we're gonna finish the color correction process by correcting the white balance of those same shots. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the shortcuts we talked about before, Command 6 for my color wheels, and Command 7 for my video scopes. And in case you didn't see the last video, I like using the color wheels here rather than using the color board. And if you want to set that as your default for when you push Command 6, just go to Final Cut Pro, Preferences, and here under Color Correction, you can choose what comes up as the default. And I have color wheels that way when I hit my shortcut Command 6 or press the color icon here, it'll bring up the color wheels. So what we need to change here is we're going to go over to our video scope and click on this RGB overlay. And now we can see we have the exposure like we did before, but overlaid we have red, green, and blue, and that's going to be what we use to correct the color. So we're going to scroll down on the color wheel and start off with temperature. So what we're going to do is move this so that the blue overlaps the green. So I'm going to slide this to the left till blue comes up. So now we see the blue and green overlap. Now I'm gonna move the tint until the red overlaps as well. And you're gonna see the blue kind of move away. We're gonna have to go back and forth until we get it right. So now the green and red's overlaid and the blue's beneath. So I'm gonna add some more. And adjust the tint a little more so they're all overlaid. And here you get pretty neutral looking before we add the saturation. So if we look at a before and after of that, it almost looks kind of white, all the colors, which is good. So then we add the saturation, the natural colors start to come through. So here we've got before and after. Looks a lot better. So let's move on to the next clip here. We're gonna do the same thing. So this one's a lot more obvious. It's gonna be easy to overlay these. So we're gonna do the same thing. Come down to temperature. I'm going to move the blue up, then tint, move the green up over the red, bring some more blue in. You can see there we need to add some red now. Right about there looks pretty good. So now we come up, grab the saturation of the master slider, and pull it up until it looks normal to us. So I'm going to change these back real quick just to show you. That's before and after. See how yellow that looked? And now the walls look the normal color, our skin tone looks normal, and we've got a good overall picture. So now moving to the last one. This one's a little bit harder to see right here, but we're going to do our best to overlay those. So I'm going to start with the blue again, bring it up over the green. This one doesn't need a whole lot. Bring the green up. More blue. Now bring the saturation up. And there, natural looking colors for that shot. It's a pretty simple process. Sometimes with images like this, it can be a little bit harder trying to line everything up, but overall, we see these. They all look pretty natural and ready to be color graded. And this is
a great way to do it using these scopes, because I used to just move sliders around and just do what kind of looked right to my eye. But what I'd find is I would overdo it one way, then have to come back and redo it, and I'd then overdo it the other way. But using these scopes, you can see what the actual colors are, line stuff up how they're supposed to be, and then you'll get the right colors for your shots.
And that's it. Just a few simple steps using those white balance tools to take your image from having too much of one color to being a well-balanced neutral image that you can now use to start your color grading. And the easiest way to color grade is to just put a LUT on top of it, but I'm going to show you how to use your editing software's color controls to do your own color grading in another video. But if this video is helpful, then please help me out, leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you soon.